Don't you hear the Dragon Quest music? Okay, I couldn't choose where to map any of this. It was hard for me to choose where to map the buttons, but like the A button on the bottom is kind of like the X button on Sony. So basically I have to pretend that I'm playing a Sony system to effectively play this. And somehow I found a way to map B into the circle button like on Sony. So hopefully that is going to help me. Doesn't that exit look like Dragon Warrior 3? Even the castle. Let's see if I get my first battle ever. This would be my first battle ever. The walking speed on the map is bad. But the walking speed in town is better. Yeah, the stupid auto-muting. Okay, my first battle ends up being a lot of enemies. I could go to auto, maybe. Oh, wow. Oh, wow, this game has fast leveling, that means. I would have to say that that's probably fast leveling, Eden. That was a pretty quick battle. You know, no need to wait for a long time. Oh, there's already a port town? There's already a port town. These things always have chests, at least the ones that look like cabinets here, see? It's a very loud controller. Should the boat take you back? I haven't gone anywhere yet. It just started. Welcome to owning a Steam Deck, Eden. $400 for absolutely nothing, and I'm not even using the Steam Deck. I had to fucking, like, resort to inconveniencing myself. The laptop's supposed to be in bed so I can watch TV and shit. there's four people. You know, it's exactly like FF1. It ended up being a black belt, a warrior, you know, a monk. They call it a monk. It has basically the same six classes that FF1 lets you choose, which is really, really good news for me. Really good news for me because of how much I like that, how much I like FF1. And it looks like Dragon Quest quite heavily. These weird wisps are joining me, but they're... I'm really not sure what that means or what they do. Is it a skill? Spirit Ember 2. Okay, this is the other... I ended up picking two warriors, Shane. Just for the record, I ended up picking two warriors and two monks. I'm kind of burned out of mages because of what I did last year, and I think you missed it, Shane, because I did not know you yet. I did not know you. In 2022. Hey Shane, I will tell you, you are my you're easily my favorite person of 2023. You know, the people that clicked the follow button in 2023. Definite favorite. Ragar, for the record, clicked on that button in 2022. But I barely knew Ragar, actually, in 2022. Other than just some of the visits and whatnot. It's actually quite sad, Shane, that I said that about you. Not in the way because it's you, But it's quite sad because it's like nobody else follows or stays, if you think about it. Like, why would you go to Twitch and, like, end up following anyone? Like, no one clicks that button anymore, so it's really hard to ever have a channel. It's really, really hard. It's the hardest fucking thing I've ever done. Not to mention, Shane, your knowledge of RPGs. I do read everything you type, even if I'm focused on my game. No, this is just the laptop, but at least I got the controller to work, so the cancel and confirmation buttons are not start and select. I had to download a bunch of like third-party applications just to make the controller work for the game, and also just to be able to map the buttons for the game I'm playing. There was no other way to do it, because Steam does not have a good button mapper. Steam makes an assumption of what it thinks that you want, but the third-party program is the only way that I can play this game. But yeah, Smurfy's completely gone from the community right now. Like, I wasn't even close to mad to him at all. I don't want to return to title. That's a risky button right there. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We need to catch this dick, Ted. I just went into the first cave at random. I'm just waiting for Ragnar to come here. Actually popular, huh? Someone like me never would have been close to that. I was too busy playing RPGs and not giving a fuck about anybody else. The battle speed's very fast. Oh shit! It's mommy seeing the true username, the true actual real life name. Did the animation play that you even subbed to me? Did you guys hear the sub come in, or did it not come in? Was it one of those fake subs, mommies? Was it a fake? I didn't even see it come in. It did play it? Okay, well, I'll trust you. I'll trust you so that you can have your boost. You're welcome to join the giveaway. The giveaway is up here, basically. 5 days left until Nightbot picks a winner. Okay? So 5 days left. You may opt in for free, it says, when Nightbot chooses a winner. Subbing gives you more odds. Tier 3 sub is the best odds. The winner will literally play. You're gonna be the fucking one, mommies, to fucking play a video game, an RPG. You're gonna beat a video game and you're gonna get paid instead of the other way around, right? You're gonna fucking win. If you get to the end credits of whatever game it is, you will win $60. Or 110, maybe. That would be the game over song right there. But yeah, real quick, mommies, here, let me go to auto battle. Oh, wow, I got healed for free. For leveling up, I got healed for free. I don't know, like, I was just telling Shane that Twitch is, like, an impossible place where, like, Twitch is so old now that nobody just hits the follow button anymore, so it's really hard to have a channel. It's the hardest thing of your whole life to ever have a channel, right? So it's like I changed my name out of randomness. As the other name did not work, so I changed it, basically. It just did not work. It never did work. But now that you've subbed, go ahead and boost. Go ahead and boost one of the video games, because you will be affecting someone's life. Even if you've never played any of these games, just do something at random. You will be affecting the winner's life, which could be you. Oh, do you know something about Joker 2? Because Benka already boosted that. And it's already large, but it's about to become larger. I'll boost it right now. Oh shit, I'm looking at the wrong wheel. I hate when the colors are the same and I'm looking at the wrong wheel. I was trying to find Joker 2 and then I was on the wrong wheel. Oh, it's not going to be humongous, but it did get quite larger just now. No, I would never delete because, like, I have more to lose than anyone that's ever streamed on Twitch. I would have a very large amount of things to lose. It's 11 different years of memories being the only person that plays a legit copy of every RPG, right? So it's just too much to ever lose. Editing things here and there could be the only thing. That's about it. Oh my god, I find it funny that this game has a better encounter rate than a fucking professionally made Digimon game for the DS. A way better encounter rate. Very, very fast menuing too. I'm just in and out right away. Yeah, it's very nostalgic. It took me all day long to make the fucking game work, but the Steam Deck does not allow it to work, so this is not a Steam Deck. Thank you. I didn't know that this game had a day-night system, but it's a lot like Dragon Quest III. The class picking and then the Dragon Quest III aesthetics and whatnot. It's very nice to have a quadruple melee party. Everybody's melee, 100% melee. And the bad news is, Eden, I literally, like, have a Steam Deck to be able to fucking grind or do whatever I want by unplugging the system and going like the Switch, but guess what? You know, it doesn't work on the Steam Deck. Nothing works. The only video game out of the last 10 or 15 that actually will work. God, even those Agarest games never worked correctly. But the only game that in history that I fully beat on the deck actually ended up being Ease 8. It was Ease 8 worked. It actually worked. Enough to the fact that I got to the final boss. It's just relaxing to grind on a video game that has instant loading, unlike Digimon. Digimon, loading was not the problem, it was just the animations. There's a 60-second pause before you're allowed to start battling. Because of animation. Shouldn't that door open automatically? I feel like my camera's, like, really, like, fucked right now. I just zoomed the camera out a little, so now it looks a little bit better. Am I supposed to, key items maybe? No, that should open automatically. Hey Jake, I forgot what you followed me for, but check out the score sheet to see what's happened all year. Yeah, it looks like Dragon Quest, basically. That's why Ragnar is having me play it. I don't want to get too far out of the way. Oh, shit, I just realized that I could game over if I go... Oh, my God, if I game over, then I go all the way to the beginning to where I never even fought a single battle. Very risky. Oh, shit, this is a risky area. It took me a lot of turns just to kill one beetle. Let's try to make it here and see if there's a save spot. I think there is a safe spot and an inn. This is only a 9-hour game, Jeff. It should be 9 to 12-ish around there. I guess that counts as saving, and that's pretty much that. Yeah, I noticed you play a Steam game, and I'm like, oh shit, I better get recent over here. Ragnar donated that one time 2 weeks ago. That's why I have to play this, because of the donation. It's only going to be 10 hours, like, barely. Pour the wine into some barrel in a guard room. Whatever that even means. Oh, you didn't even give it a shot? Huh. It is like Dragon Quest, so that's why I like it. At least I'm trying to. It's too early to really know anything. It's too early to know if it's really, really great, but we'll see. I picked two black belt monks, which are just monks, and also two warriors, which are warriors. It's just like FF1. It looks like Dragon Quest, but it's like FF1. The perfect mixture. Oh, I just got 20 XP for doing that. Yeah, ripping off the FF8. So what hey Shane, what are you gonna move on to next? Now that you've obviously now that you've like beaten that damn Shadow game. Looks like this person is holding one of those weird things that can help join me. Healing water. Wait, where did that guy go? I filled the wine and everything. Is he gone? What the hell? He gave me 5,000 bucks and now he's just straight up gone. I see, an auto trans, huh? There is a world map on Steam, on Steam walkthroughs. There's a world map here. Okay, well, let's see. I think I might know where I am. Yeah, I think I know where I am. There's a mine. There's a mine to the upper left. It's not that big of a world map. Ragar, I don't know. I'm not sure why Smurfy had to block my whole community, but like, Ragar's trying to, instead of coming to the stream, Ragar is trying to make a video tutorial of how to make this game work on a Steam Deck. But the thing is, though, like, I'm already getting far, and I don't want to start from the beginning again, even if it does ever work on a deck. Because the cloud saving is like, what the hell, man? Like, I can't find the cloud saving option. I just don't understand it at all. Like, where the fuck is the cloud saving option? I tried loading this game on the deck and the computer and a laptop. And none of the quests carried over. It was all different. Yeah, that's just stupid to me. How fucking hard is it just to toggle the cloud saving on, you know, unless there is none because the fucking developer is an idiot. It's probably just some stupid kid playing making an indie game. A little bit more XP might be up this way. I feel like there's a lot of wasted room in this layout because this game is really old school. Oh, cool. Huh, this is kind of a... This might be the better layout to actually use. It seems that it's the better layout to use. I just have to get the logo for the game. Let's go back to this layout and copy the logo over. Copy. Back to this layout and paste. It's an adventure to find random artifacts for absolutely no reason whatsoever. Oops, I just went to the left by accident. Now there's a super enemy up here. Brand new enemies I've never seen. And they are attacking brutally hard. Good thing Otto's nice and lazy for me. The experience is quite incredibly good. So this will be the new level up spot. I'll definitely save. I don't know if I want to waste that kind of money on the inn. It's nighttime inside of here now, because it's nighttime, period. Oh, this is actually a deposit place. That might be good. Wait, what about depositing money? Okay, maybe I can't deposit money, just those dumb items. I have nothing of value at all, though. Arrow times 15. There's a bullet, but bullet's not here right now. Where's the damn weapons at? Oh, this is weapons and armor. My fault. Player hater Mike, Borg, and Alex. Hey, Shane. Shane, I put Borg and I put Alex. I literally stole two characters. I named everybody after the people that were in chat. So Mike is Shockstorm, but Mike is also the default name. It's the default name, and it's also Shockstorm's real name, and that's what he wanted because that's what his name is on Steam, or that's what Shockstorm's name is on Discord. It's Mike instead of Shockstorm. But yeah, Player and Mike, I believe, are the two warriors. Player Hater and Mike. The game itself is, I'm barely far at all, but I'm just reminded of Dragon Quest III right now, pretty much in every way. Cannot equip the hand axe? Wait, why would that warrior be able to equip the hand axe, but... Oh, it's because he's a monk. What the fuck? Something happened with my order. Something happened with my, like, actual order. That's odd. I'm gonna have to do the hand axe for both of the warriors. I picked two warriors and two monks. Maybe I should make a note of that in the stream layout. The monks should not be able to equip anything because they use fists. They're into fisting. The warriors are gonna be the dudes that stay alive the most, just because they'll have all the heavy armor and shit. I'm running out of money just a smidge now. Much more than a smidge. Commoner's garb, I gotta sell that. It looks like I just need a very large amount of more money now to upgrade even more. The sword was only worth $5. Oh god. I can't believe that, here, let me go to formation. The two monks should be in the back. Technically in the back. These two are warriors. Is this the whole town or something, or what is this? It's kind of hard to see because of it's nighttime right now. Elixirs of strength are often in those cabinets. The objective with those mini people is you gotta hit the A button on them quickly. I don't think anything's ever in these jars, these FF4 jars. No, the town is bigger than I thought. Hey, Eden, I need to tell you something about this game, actually. I very definitely need to tell you something about this game. So, this is not exactly the FF1 that you might be thinking of, or the Dragon Quest 1, 2, or 3. It might be closer to Dragon Quest 2 because of the wide openness. It's actually kind of irony. It's ironic irony. It's ironic irony that, I know that's redundant, but it's ironic irony that this game is very, very close to Romancing Saga 3, the very first and the only game in the history of my stream where I just quit. I just fucking quit, Eden. I quit right away, dude. It was just done so freaking fast. Romancing Saga 3, the biggest pile of garbage. But it's funny because this game is Romancing Saga. You know, it's like Romancing Saga. It's completely, like, open to just kind of do anything and go anywhere. The objective is to kill that, like, creature that I whispered you about earlier. In the morning time, I whispered you about that thing that you're supposed to kill, and that's the only objective, Eden. That's it. That's literally it. But in saying so, that's actually way, way more than, it is way more than Romancing Saga ever went to. Like, at least there's a fucking objective, you know? And at least the battle system is extremely easy and balanced, and I'm not just dying instantly, you know. It's not a pile of garbage like Romancing Saga. It's super easy to play it and to level up and whatnot, and to generally understand it too. Romancing Saga's battle system is based on Saga, so the way that you get more powerful is to just kind of do random things, but they really failed at that. They really failed at that because, you know, Romancing fails at that because they didn't make it good, like really good, like Saga 1, Saga 2, Saga 3. They did not make it like that. They made it, the Romancing games, they made it really bad, like extra bad. Just trying to get a battle to appear, but no luck. Where is that Digimon encounter rate that we need here? I bought new weapons for the two warriors. My best course of action might be to, like, state what classes I pick so anybody knows. Okay, I'm adding text to the stream. Text is being added. This is an all melee quest that I've chosen. Oops, I forgot to do that. And then put it right under the classes that I chose. I gotta make the font bigger than that. I literally did not feel like picking any mages because Eden remembers last year. Because when I played FF1 on the PS1 and I picked mages only. You know, I did a mage only challenge or whatever. It was not much of a challenge for me. I'm used to FF1 extremely. So this game I did the opposite. I went with two warriors, two monks. At least with the warriors I'll be able to like wear equipment, like powerful equipment. If I did four monks, it would have been boring to like see a new weapon and then not be able to wear it at all. This game might end up a little bit too directionless, like Romancing. Like, I don't even know if there's much of a point to this cave. I think I need to afford that key that was being sold in the town. The only way to afford that key is to fucking grind. Oh my god, that crab looks like Dragon Quest III. The red crab from Dragon Quest III. That was really good money and XP. There's a discolored tree over here. It might be an area. I picked such a powerful party. I didn't even know this game had auto battle, but when you go to auto battle with a melee only party, then you're gonna plow through a game like this, man. 100%. You have this weird tree. At least the walking speed goes back to being fast when you're in an area. I feel like I don't want to risk going too far, but I'm already really far in this place, oh shit. Oh, crap. I critted, and he didn't even die. Thank God. Oh, one damage? Oh, this is where I need magic, clearly. Clearly need magic. Everybody's only doing one. Oh, I critted again! This is going a little bit better than Digimon, at least. Yeah, some kind of armor break in some fashion, but everybody leveled up and got healed for free. A zombie, which is very good news. I'm getting a little deep in this place, but whatever. What are you playing lately, zombie? Remnant 2, that was a fast reply. That was a really fast reply, my god. Never scare me like that again. You're in Australia and your reply was that fucking fast? That seems to be a bit of a dead end right there. Hey, zombie, the timer is still going for, here, I'll just do the giveaway bot command, watch this. The timer is still going. Five days left until that giveaway thing. The challenge giveaway. My dream wheel will spin. And you, zombie, you could be the one that's fucking forced. You could be the one, zombie, that's forced to play a game from my beloved wheel. And you will beat the game and you will fucking win money. The tables will be fucking reversed. And you'll enjoy yourself, goddammit. You will enjoy yourself. Holy crap, these dudes are attacking a bit too much. The last two hits block. Please don't die. I don't have any fucking white mages. I need to hightail the hell out of here. Start using my heals. I've never used a heal in this entire game yet, so let's get ready to use a heal. That was extremely massive XP, though. Imagine if there was a save state. Boosts MP. Wait, what the hell is all this? Oh, that's max! Oh my god, these elixirs are for max! I'm gonna have to... Oh, crap. Oh, that was magic. I don't think I have magic, though. Nobody has magic. Wait, this warrior has magic, but the other one does not. I'll give him 5 in case he gets magic. The monks barely have HP. Mysterious water that soothes pain? Soothes pain? It soothed everybody equally in the whole party. I obtained a bottle of sap. It's like Sigma, he's a poor sap. The sap? Oh, the sap might be a key item? I don't even know why it turns gray when I hit A on it, but okay. I've never seen this eagle before, but it might be rough. A good critical to start things. Is always a good thing. At least the battles load immediately, unlike Digimon. Oh, my first fucking death, you bitch! The first B word and the first fucking death, dude. God damn it. Son of a bitch, right when Shockstorm gets here. Is Shockstorm the one that's dead too? Oh no, Shockstorm leveled up, so he's alive. Oh my god, this game's brutal, that means. There's no automatic reviving after battle. I'm gonna have to run the fuck out of here and always go to run away. Failed to escape is not ever a fun thing. Okay, where's that runaway bracelet when I need it from Digimon? I need to escape this dungeon and fucking revive, or I'm gonna be game overing. Bitch. I'm trying to run so that the dead person does not get way behind on the level that everyone's in. I got really greedy to even do this dungeon at all. Everyone's starting to just drop like flies. Come on, a monk should be able to run really easy. I need to make it back to town or it's gonna be a permanent game over. I just healed with whatever the fuck I had left. That was very, very fucking brutal, Shockstorm. I'm going in these damn dungeons too early. I know that the inn does not revive me, so I need to find a way to revive from a clinic. The FF1 clinic. Maybe this little shrine town does not even have... Doesn't even have a shrine. Oh no, this dude revives people. See, I couldn't fight a battle with a dead unit, or he's just going to be way too many levels behind. I might have a little tiny bit more money now to afford equipment. Shockstorm? I need to tell Shockstorm something. This is really insane. Oh my god. Looks like buying medical herbs for a monk-only party that I have, a warrior monk-only party. Buying a large amount of medical herbs is the only way that I'll be able to stay alive, ever. Oh wow, smoke bombs are too expensive. I'm just flooding my inventory with heals. Okay, why is Borg way behind on defense? That's weird. And at least it's solved now. Shockstorm, if Shockstorm's at work, then I'm not gonna be able to really like say what's going on with Rhaegar. Basically, like, Rhaegar, like, I really, really, really need Rhaegar to be here right now, because, like, this is a Romancing Saga game. This is a very good game, but it's like Romancing Saga. The bad part of it is, like, it's completely wide open. So it's a directionless game, I think. But I'm happy that it's easy, you know, it's FF1 easy, right? Or it's like, Dragon Quest easy. All I have to do is grind. No big deal, but instead of coming here, Rhaegar decided to make me he's making me a YouTube video walkthrough of how to make this game run on the fucking deck. And guess what? The fucking cloud saving is not working in between my computer, my laptop, which is this. This is my laptop. It's not working in between any of the three things or the deck, any of the three things. So it's like, even if he gives me this tutorial that he's making for me, on his own YouTube, you know, like, my save here probably will not carry over. Because there seems to be no save. How is Alex dead already? That makes no sense. Did anybody see how Alex died? Because that makes absolutely no fucking sense. We just came fresh from a safe spot. Oh, I have to bring them to the front? Okay, that's really weird. He's got 1 HP after the revival, just like Dragon Quest or FF1. No, it's not working at all, Shockstorm. It still cannot load. Even for Smurfy, it does not load, even for Smurfy. This is called a laptop. I'm on the stupid laptop. I'm on the stupid laptop. It took a while. I had to download a third-party program just to allow myself to pick which buttons I want. I want A to be A, and I want B to be B, Shockstorm. Did you know that the start and select buttons were the A and the B buttons? Like, what the fuck? Are you bullshitting me, Shockstorm? Why the fuck would I want to play a video game where A and B are start and select, and all of these colored buttons don't do anything? It just makes no goddamn sense. So, yeah, he's, the Steam Deck does not work, but he's making a full video guide. He might be able to help a lot of people, though, that want to play this. I might have the game beaten before he can make a video like that, though. The checkerboard, enemy animation. Uh-oh, these are those stupid rocks again. I have to kill these, like, orange enemies. I've never manually selected an enemy in my life. I went to auto battle for everything so far. I need these crits to start working, or this is going to be a bad level up spot. It's not a good level up spot anyway. Yeah, the game is only working on laptop, remember. He really did. Like, he's on the Legends wall, by the way. Like, someone like that should not just, like, end up giving up. The only person that I would ever see giving up is a certain person called Captain Skyhawk with 2 Ks. It's only because we fight all the time about 7R and Tears of the Kingdom and whatnot, but... Yep, I can't even type a message to Smurfy. I'm blocked because he's out of the community. That means he defriended me. He defriended me as well, because there's no way to talk to him. Blocked and left. Huh, I would rather almost go to the inn to heal that instead of waste my medical herb. He should have just blocked me for like a day instead of like went to the full resort of doing that. I know, he did an hour before he blocked me and left, I mean. He literally just did it an hour before that. Oh my god, that's a lot of money for the inn. Okay, that was a bad idea. I used the inn. It was more expensive. Oh well. I got my monk out front. Let's get one of the warriors out front. Okay, those stone monsters are a bit rough. Coffee, if it was you. if it was you instead, it would have been a celebration stream. I would have added, like, extra giveaways of Dragon Quest. It would have been, like, the best day of my life stream instead of the worst day of my life stream, so... Hey, Coffee! Did you know that I spied on you? I fucking spied on you. During Zelda 2. I think it was after I was all done for the night with Digimon. It's always high school up in this channel. Coffee, I saw you die on just a stupid orange like regular enemy. Treasures, yeah. Oh, you picked up the Steam version? Wow. Hey, Zombie, I know that I gave it like a 60-something, but if you actually like gifted to me, oh my god, how much money is it? Because I'll give you a few spins. I don't think I'll ever play it again on the Switch, because it's just slower. It's slower on the Switch. It'll be faster the other way. But that's only if you feel like having it, any kind of lucky spins. I love the auto battle option. It's very good to pick all melee fighting characters. I think I might use one of those medical herbs on whoever that is. It just shows the second person. Oh yeah, I still have those elixirs of life. Okay, the monk needs it, and he needs to be healed. And I might even have more. Nope, all medical herbs for that person. And I still have an elixir of strength. That will help. I don't care who I use it on, I'll just give it to Player. Player Hater showed up to the early stream, so I named him after one person. Crap, am I going too far away from whatever town was? I see a bridge, but I feel like I'm going too far away. Okay, these look like the green Peets from FF1 right here. Absolutely. The green Peet from FF1. Oh, he dodged that bitch. But as always, the door's locked. It's kind of like Dragon Quest 1. I have to have a key item, or just generally a key, to talk to the wise person. Dragon Quest 1 mixed with FF1. I better get out of here before the enemies completely decimate me. This is going to be a very powerful party on attacking, because it's all melee. It is all melee. Gonna be beautiful. Oh, I think there's a town right here. I just kind of missed it the first way up. The town of Foren. Foren with two R's, E-N. Foren. It's only $80 to rest. Not bad. The inn song is a little cheesy. Buy a new PC, Zombie? Buying a new PC is priority one. Bunch of new weapons, I guess. Longbow? I don't have the money, so it's not letting me see who can equip it. Isn't that stupid, Zombie? just because I don't have the money, I'm not allowed to see. I'm not even allowed to see what I can go for to buy. Like, what if the warriors can equip longbow? Then I would need to pre-plan to save up for the longbow. But now there's no way of telling. Apparently you can go kill the final boss right away. Something about a sword that I was just given, and he might be able to upgrade it to a flame sword or something. Foren, the name of the town was obtained. The last few towns had these damn keys for sale. It diminishes my ability to get equipment when I'm buying expensive keys. Few towns had expensive keys to buy. Not gonna be able to do that for a bit. It's literally about a 10-hour game. You just have to keep playing it to get powerful enough, because the only goal is kill the final boss. That's the entire game. At least it's a nice quickie kind of game. Quick loading and quick auto battling. I could have done four monks and saved a lot of money, though, on all this equipment. But sometimes warrior just stays alive. If the monk dies quicker, the warrior just stay alive. That was very brutal just now. Player's about to be basically dead. Literature? Some kind of blast. Whoa! Holy shit! Oh my god, 3 level ups. Oh Jesus, the one fucking person that did not level up is the one that's almost dead. Here's yet another cave, but I gotta stop risking it. What just happened there? I went to auto battle and he used a super move instead of just attacking. And the battle ended. That was very nuts. I only got 1,000 gold right now. This is a dungeon? Indeed it is. I'm gonna use that strength seed right away. Fortitude. I'll give him magic because he might need it later. I'll just give him everything that he just had. Just making sure no one else has seeds. If you were given a quest on this with a team that was already grinded, you could just beat the game instantly. So there's nothing blocking me from beating the game other than my level. That's it. The objective of the game, Sigma, is to just kill the final boss, and that's it. So, in the meantime, I'm supposed to grind for 9 hours, and then that's about it. I can find some shit along the way, like equipment and whatnot, to make me better. Maybe even, like, some spells and whatnot to make me better. I'm on the laptop, Sigma. Not where I want to be. But at least it's running using the controller correctly now. Instead of incorrect. It looks like I ran out of that literature move. I just need a critical hit or there's no way to kill rocks. There's no way to kill a rock unless I get... There's no way to kill a rock, Sigma. Unless I hire the McMahon-Helmsley era to take over. Then it'll be very easy. Fuck. Oh, come on, I thought that was a crit. Everybody's doing 1-1-1. Oh, now I get the crit after someone dies and lost out on all the XP? Dumb bitch. Now I have to run away from every battle on the way back to town. Cause I don't wanna get fucked on the XP amount for that person. Oh my god, Sigma, did I just go to auto battle by accident? I got someone else killed. Did Randy Orton kick Rock's ass or something? Back in 04? Too many deaths right now, I forgot where I even ended up. If Ragar ends up getting here, he's gonna have to understand that I've been roaming around doing nothing. Holy shit, I'm about to be at the game over screen for sure. Running away is too hard and they're doing 35 on me. I do not know where I am at all. I need a town, any town, does not matter what. I see a town through the fucking river. 30 damage plus poison. Oh my god, I ended up game overing. Let me guess, the game crashes when you game over. No, I'm not updating the journal. I just fucking fully game over, you dumb bitch. Oh my god, everybody's dead and I have to re-revive from scratch. What the fuck town is this? Oh, versus The Rock, Mick Foley. Where the fuck is the reviving, bitch? No, I do not want that key. 660? I don't have enough money to revive one person. I won't even have enough money to use the inn. They should have just revived me for free. We already got to the game over screen. Alright, I'm selling all of these bullets. Just don't tell Bullet, Sigma. Just don't tell Bullet. Why would it cost hundreds and hundreds and hundreds just to revive one fucking piece of shit person? Like, if it comes down to it, I might have 1 HP left, $0 left, and then I would game over every time a battle starts, and then I cannot continue the game anymore. FF and Dragon Quest made the revival fee a lot cheaper than that. Just so you could actually get back on your feet instead of start a new quest from scratch. The point of an RPG is that you don't fucking start a new fucking quest from scratch. Dumb bitch. You're getting buffering? Oh, I was just saying that I forgot about, you know, the Rock and Mick. That must have been after Mick Foley lost the I Quit match where he had to quit because of Triple H, but that was like years before that. Obviously, he still ended up finding a way to come back to the company. Randy's team won. And that's why he was a rock killer. He was a legend killer, that's why. Just to tell you guys, everybody has seen like 33% of the whole world map already, just from me walking around at random. It's a small game, I guess. Very small game. Backlash is usually like right after, I think, so yeah. What year was it when Triple H ended up winning the I Quit match? Because he was supposed to be fired permanently, but they brought him back anyway. All the doors are always locked in this game, and I don't know why. Oh, that was way back in 00. So Mick was already almost basically like done because his body took enough. Oh my god, if you hold down A, it's extra fast. I'm just getting brutalized by attacks. Remember when Triple H made fun of him for being fired and he was at the unemployment line and shit like that? Yeah, he's the one that wore the weird mask and the fucking like white t-shirt or the white office shirt. Unless he was Cactus Jack, he was different looking. Mick Foley is the best iteration, or Mankind is the best iteration of him. A boring inn song. I didn't see that was a cave there. Holy crap, he wasted the super spell or whatever. And now I'm out of it. I'm just risking going into a new cave. Nothing there. Lots of chests here. No, that's what I call XP, though, my god. 1,000 bucks obtained, fatal bullet, and 1,000 again. Now this is what I call a good cave. That was a very brutal battle right there. I don't have any white mages, so there's no choice but medical herb. Nothing but medical herb. The gravel on the ground is basically like Dragon Quest graphics. Hey, Coffee, what level are you in on Zelda 2? Yeah, the I Quit match, they called it. Yeah, he was Mankind. I have to go back to the running away strategy because I have a death right now. There's gotta be a fucking revival in this game. Fuck! There needs to be a canoe too so I can fucking float through that. Holy shit, I made it to town with no battles. $500 just to revive one person. That is sickening for prices. It's not even fair, not even close to fair. Actually, Cactus Jack, I think, was the one that he had an I Quit match with. It was Cactus Jack, dude. That was the last match that he ever did because his wife wanted him to quit wrestling forever. Cactus Jack versus Triple H, the ultimate match. Actually, before I run out of money, let's see if anybody can equip any of this fucking garbage. Defense goes way down for that weapon? Weird. I'll just buy the other breastplate. Commoner's garb this late in the game? Well, not really late. I'm gonna go back into that cave. It was a good risk to get some of the chests and whatnot. Here's another one of the chests now. It looks like I could do that super move just one time and then I am out of it. Some kind of weird spell. An Elixir of Guile. Hey, Coffee, the ironic part about this game is like this is the type of game that is the perfect thing to calm me down from all the fucking tech support issues that I'm having. Because it literally is FF1 mixed with Dragon Quest. Which is literally perfection. All right, I'm getting a little bit too deep in this place now, but let's see. I should just probably buy massive amounts of heals. Don't fucking die. How did the one on the left stay alive after all those attacks? The one on the right, oh my god, now he's dead. If I level up now, then I'll be able to heal for free. For everybody. I'm gonna have to sell that fatal bullet. I like that water, it healed everybody, it's beautiful. There's Ragar. Ragar, it sounds like two people need new computers. Oh my god, I hope you do a back-to-school sale as well. I just need a good CPU that can run XSplit, like, efficiently. So, were you trying to make a video for me, literally? Or like, what have you been trying to do? If he dies here, man, I am really screwed. Oh, bitch! Fuck. I can't. Oh my god, I have to stay in this battle. I got two deaths. It might turn out pretty good, zombie. Zombie, never give up hope. It might turn out pretty good. Holy shit, that was poison. Oh my god, there's no escape spell. There's no way to escape. It's a very long dungeon, and I have to somehow escape here. No, I went to auto. I did not mean doing that. I did not mean to. It looks like the first two characters are going to be very massively, massively underleveled because they're fucking dead right now. They're not gaining any XP at all. I ended up finding the end of the dungeon, maybe? I think it's the end. Where is the thing that I just found? It's not the gray sword. There it is, the hunter's blade. It needs to be given. In very old school fashion, it needs to be manually given. So all that walking for a weapon that's only nine damage better. Hey Ragar, what does the game over system do in this series? Because I might have to take a game over. Like, I can't go through two floors. I have to keep trying to run, but the running rate is really bad, as you can see. I'm about to game over just because I'm trying to run. But I can't allow Player and Alex to be out of XP so badly that they're massively underleveled. Now it's just down to Mike and then a game over. Oh, this was the Gray Sword Cave. Motherfucker. Yeah, I did already game over, but I wasn't sure if they took me back to my save or whatever they did, but I did have to revive everybody from scratch, and it cost me every dime that I had. Every single dime of money that I ever had. I'm gonna have to take the game over right now, even on purpose. I'm just gonna keep going to run and then wait for the game over to happen. Because I'm effed now. This game is random, Ragar. Like, if you were here, you might have told me where to go, but I don't know where to go. I'm just walking at random, dude. Totally walking at random. There's the game over. I walked on fucking poison, so... I have to keep the game over because I got so many fucking key items just now. I have no choice but to keep the game over, but every penny that I made is gone now because the revival fee is so much fucking worse. So much fucking worse than Dragon Quest. So much worse than FF1. FF1 at least is $80 to revive. Big fucking deal. And it's not allowed to go up. The $80, it is not allowed to go up. Fucking bullshit. The revival fee broke the game in the favor of rage quitting. I'm gonna have to sell the fatal bullet just to make money. And the hand axe. I'm lucky that I even had that fatal bullet, but now I don't have the fatal bullet. He caused 444 to revive, so it's progressively brutal. The only thing I want to do is, like, just level up. The objective is to kill the final boss, and then the game is permanently over with. And the only thing I can do is just fucking grind, and that's it. I keep thinking that I'm only going to grind for hours and hours of streaming, but then I keep just going into caves and getting tempted and tempted and tempted. Yeah, I only have... It says who I chose on the right side of the screen. The monks are pretty bad at staying alive because they just don't have armor. Wait, where did that one greysword go? Wasn't I supposed to do something? It's called a red sword now? What the fuck? I have a warp spell? Oh my god, it's letting me go back to that specific town. Alright, I forgot who wanted it, but it might be this town. Potentially this town. It was him. Flame blade obtained. Now I'm gonna wreck some shit, bitch. Now I'm gonna wreck some shit. Fuck yeah. Somebody leveled up because of that, but he's so far behind that he's in level 8 still. Fuck. There's the flame blade. Monks are not allowed to have it. Holy shit, dude. I'm gonna upgrade Borg. You notice how there's an Alex and there's a Borg? I'll give it to Borg, I guess. Wait. The Hunter's Blade can go to the other person now, because it's better than the junk that he has. And that means I can sell the old thing, whatever it may be. It's a nice little time-passing game, right? I don't know if it would get a 75, but like, it feels like it should, because I love the pacing. I love the pacing of battle. The encounter rate is better than Digimon. The encounter rate's better than that, and the speed of battle is massively better than everything that I ever play, because we're on Steam and it's just instant loading and super speed. That was kind of a good level-up dungeon, though, to be honest. Hey, Ragar, one thing I haven't had money for is to pay $1,500 for a key, and then $5,000 in this town for a different key. I think that's a little ridiculous, so I'm gonna have to, like, wait until I have that kind of money to buy those keys. But then I don't know where they're used. I'm not sure where they're perfectly used. These beetles are so goddamn hard. I can't even believe it. I won because I wasted the super move, but now I don't have the super move anymore. It's gone. He's got gray hair for some reason. I'm gonna switch. Switch to him. These beetles are rough. Hey, Ragar, what does this Steam Deck guide that you try to have, what does this entail me doing exactly for this game to work on a deck? What am I supposed to do? Maybe it's what Smurfy was trying to have me do, but he fucking just literally, like, blocked the community. Holy shit, I have a death already? There's gotta be a reviving item in this game at some point. Oops, I'm just literally talking to the wrong person. Oh yeah, I should probably buy... at least buy more heals. There's the smoke bomb, but it's expensive. Oh, the desktop mode thing that Smurfy would have done? Yeah, he, I can't believe it, dude. He's been around for 7 years, and he's extremely pissed off. I fucking smacked my Steam Deck in anger, and that had nothing to do with Smurfy. Smacking that piece of shit has nothing to do with Smurfy. And by the way, there's no way that you can tell if it works to stream it. Remember, if you go to my VOD and see me smash my Steam Deck in anger, before the smash, you will see that the only thing that you could see is the logo of the deck, but the desktop mode is only for my eyes, so that means a streamer can't fucking stream the deck. Streamers are not allowed to stream the deck on desktop mode, period. No, I'm not putting that on YouTube. It was a tech support stream, so there's no point. There's no point to uploading that as episode one of Artifact. You know, because it was such a tech support stream that I couldn't do anything in the game at all. It's on Twitch because I did a morning stream, and it's on Twitch, period, and that's it. This will be the first episode of, you know, this game. Every time I die, I have to walk all the way back to a clinic. Maybe the monks were a bad idea, because they do instantly die, often and quickly. I need to go to formation, because something's fucked. Like, these assholes need to be in the front. Well, hopefully a warrior can use a spell, because if not, it's going to be rough. It's going to be very rough to play this. It has Dragon Quest's death system, so that's really good. Very good news that I don't have to go back to a title screen. Yeah, I don't think they ever even had weapons, or maybe they do and I don't know it. Oh, yeah, actually he had a dirk, so that was useless. And, oh, they came with dirks. Wait, I mean... It's funny their attack went up because I did that. Oh my god, you were right. You were right. I mean, it's only six more points. Not damage, but just only six more points. So I don't know how much better they're gonna be per se. Hopefully they're kind of better. Yeah, I have the world map up, and then I have the really long walkthrough up. But it's not really a walkthrough, because it's like Romancing Saga. Where's the final boss at on the world map? Is he in the desert tower? Because that looks really elaborate. Or is he in the ice tower, maybe? There's a forest tower, a desert tower, and an ice tower. Interesting. But the whole game is optional. Everything and everything is optional. Are those monks actually attacking better now? Let's see, the monks are Alex and Player. Let's pay attention to Alex and Player. See what they do. Alright, Night God is being a piece of crap right now. It seems that I'm gaining MP from those consumables that I find, so that's true. That is true. He ends up hitting a crit. Finally. At least I'm finally killing the beetles within a round instead of taking tons of rounds. You're kidding, okay. Huh. I'm actually not sure where you mean. Is it near the bandit's hideout with all that poison? The only poison area that I see is something called Bandit's Hideout. Barrier Village as well. Swamp King Castle. Oh yeah, that must be him then. It's just like Dragon Quest 1. He's like in between a swamp area. He's the Swamp King instead of the Dragon Lord. Alright, I'm gonna have to make Lev guilty for ignoring this one. What kind of level do you think is required for me to really beat the game? I hope there's a town nearby the final dungeon, because I'll need to continuously go back to that town to heal. Wow, I thought I couldn't attack these rocks much. I'm not sure how to heal poison in this game, because he's poisoned. I think I bought antidotes recently. But I'm not sure otherwise how to heal poison. At least I'm already past level 10 on the only stream for this game. It does take a while to kill these fucking beetles. Brutal. Maybe the reviver dude can, because that's what he does on Dragon Quest, so I don't know. Yeah, this is the only stream, technically, because the other one was a tech support. This is the first stream of this game, because the other one was a very bad tech support stream that failed. The only thing I accomplished was picking my people. I never did a battle, ever. It sucks having two people way back. Oh, yeah, this is the first stream, yeah. Not the last one. I think I've beaten an RPG once in only two streams, though. Something really short. Forgot what it was. Looks like Mike is poison. Mike is Shockstorm's Discord name, because that's his name. I'm kind of like him, because I got Borg and I got Alex. I'm tired of him getting poisoned, but I guess that's what those fucking creatures do. I don't remember buying that many tonics, but I suppose that was a good thing. Hey, Ragar, if you were to take over the directions for me to not get lost, can you tell me where to go? I could backtrack all the way to the first town of the game if you want me to, and then you could just tell me where the fuck I should go. Because it is complete randomness when you play this game. It's pure randomness. If you review today's entire VOD, though, I might have accomplished a few things. I'll show you the key item menu. Oh, I'm getting tonics as drops in battle. So, here's the key item. I have Bottle of Sap. I have the Authority of Kings from the beginning, I think. Oh, that's the warp spell. I keep forgetting to just use warp. I've got a few deaths. I'm gonna fucking revive all my money away now. Bitch. $1,300 just to revive that fuck. I have enough money for the random ass key. You know the weird key? Here, let's just do this, Ragar. I'm gonna buy the $5,000 key, and you tell me where to go. Buy the foreign warehouse key. And now where do I go with it? Oh, I can just get these weird things. He's the one that gained that power because he was the one walking. Oh, what the hell? I ended up choosing... Oh, I only chose one door. Fuck. Healing mist. You know I have to hit reset, Ragar. Oh man, that's brutal. I have to go to close game. Return to title. Ooh, I fucked up hard. Oh, that was a huge fuck up. It was a very lucky for me that I even saved. Now this is my quest, right? Good. Good thing I saved. And the third one was what again? It's a shield, defensive artifact. This game is called Artifact after all. Oh, should I have given this to him? What if I should give it to him at all, or... Let's see who I should give it to, I'm not sure. It's 9 MP, well, I guess Mike is the perfect person because he has 30. So he already was the perfect person. Okay, the next time I see such a room, I'm gonna have to hopefully there's gonna be reviving in this game later. Yeah, it mentioned buffing defense. Now, I could backtrack to the previous town, and I think it's like $2,500 for another artifact. Do you know who made this game? Was it some random kid? Like, just fucking around on RPG Maker? It's a competent little product. It probably deserves to only be a 70, but it feels much more addicting than that because of the speed. I don't remember if this town had... This town might not actually have an artifact in it. No, there's definitely something here. See, this one is 2,500. Let's see what it is. The left room is... Wait a minute, if you're dead, you get back on your feet? What? If you fall asleep, you're back. And the right side is, If you're paralyzed, you'll be stopped from that. So, I think revival is on the left one. I think he said left, right? Yeah, you can just let me know about warping. I need to save up 25 hundo now to get what seems to be revive. Literally revive. Wonder if that one dungeon is a little easier now. Alex is always dead last at leveling up. Just like in real life. Such a loud controller I have. This might be the best little cave to get 2,500 bucks. And that should be a lot quicker to do compared to 5,000. Okay, so those things are going to be warp items every time, then. Well, the inns don't matter as much as the stupid clinic. The clinic is brutal prices. Brutal. I wish I could affect the encounter rate to be high while I'm grinding. Thank you. The XP is pretty nice. Let's go to status for the very first time. I only need to kill like 4 battles and then I'll level up. What is Spirit of Stell though? Is it a spell? Oh, bitch. Oh, bitch, 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 bitch. Oh, bitch. Fuck! The first character showing always dies the quickest. I don't have the money to revive him, so he's about to get way behind on experience points. For if I have to grind while he's dead, then I'm fucked. I have to sell cleansing tonics just to have the kind of money to revive him. There's a storage in this game, but not money, no money storage. He barely survived on the money. Oh, bitch. I don't have enough for the inn now. I don't have a dime for the inn now. He doesn't have enough magic for using magic to heal. They should have never made reviving thousands and thousands of dollars. Yeah, if it's a passive, it still sounds good to me, because this party has no white mage. I don't have a white mage. I have to use this end because it's just close. Steam says that you played this game for 10 hours, so that you must beat the game. I'm gonna have to go back to the old towns and see if there's a way to like warp to fast travel to them by finding that secret item in each of the towns. Do you happen to know if this town has the secret item that unlocks the fast travel for it? Because this place is too tiny and does not seem to have anything at all. I'm gonna have to go back further. Well, it should have been in plain sight if there was a fucking, you know, thing for me to get. That would be correct, Reltek. If you were a fucking Zoomer. If you were a Zoomer child. You were a Zoomer child the whole time, Reltek? You're not a 40-year-old man? Oh my god, dude. And here I thought you were a fucking 40-something-year-old man. I believe this is the first town in the game, Ragar. We need to find the fast travel in this place. Oh yeah, I forgot, it had the castle. The castle's in the exact same spot as Dragon Quest III. That's very funny. The early stream was extremely bad. It was all tech support. It was all tech support, and then Smurfy blocked my community and left. He left and no one can whisper him, so he's very, very mad right now. All because of tech support. See, the thing is, Ragar, this was always locked, by the way. That was always locked, and that might be where I need to be going. Oh, this is this weird guy. Oh shit, him again? Wait a minute. Oh, I can't press A on any of them. But I can when I can in the world. Here, let me just get out of here. Oh, that's what I've caught? Okay, so it's showing me what I caught. I can't believe I caught that much already. Oh, maybe the artifact is super hidden, like right here in the flowers? South center. I just went to the south center. Huh. Oh, maybe I should have it? It would be showing if I really had it. That's weird. Why the fuck would my game not allow it to happen? I don't think I have anything like that. Oh, I do have King's Return, technically, yeah. Is he out of MP already? God damn it. My MP dude, you know, has all the damn spells, but he needs them. So does the zero MP spell take me to this first town then? Because the inn is a very good price, or it's an okay price. $20, I suppose. So King's Return is always here. So if I move away from it and use it, it always goes to the first town. Okay, let's try to find another town and find the fast travel for the next town. Let me get my trusty map out to see what the hell Greenvale is. Greenvale is the one that's really far up, so this is not it. Come to me, Battles, come to me. Hey, Reltek, this game has a way better encounter rate than Digimon, at least. No battles just now. No battles on an entire journey. It has to be daytime? Well, bitch. I'll just use the inn. Oh, it's even cheaper here for the inn. $12. Digimon was a 67, so it's in the orange. Like, if you get a 67 in school, Reltek, which I know you never, ever got, because you got all straight A's, you fucker. But, 67 is a D. It is literally a D in school. Maybe a D+, but probably not a D+. It's just a flat D. Oh, the encounter rate. Okay, well, enough of my talking then. you know what? This might be it right here. Oh yeah, the encounter rate was the worst in 2023 out of everything I've played. The worst. Oh, the kid by the well? Greenvale Warp is officially obtained. Should I try to obtain this blue thing here? I have to go to some mine in the west and find his son, and it might be easy to do now because I'm leveled up a little bit. No, I'll be buying that. I will be buying that, but playing a game that I already played in the 2020s is a little repetitive. Like, I'll buy it right away for sure, instantly. But I could wheel it in a year, maybe in 1 year or something. I'll wheel it. But I did play it in the 2020s. If I get a flat D, call your doctor. Oh jeez. Which dungeon does that person want me to go in? Oh, Southeast Guard. Okay. I'll just go to the Southeast Guard then. Oh, the cave is north of here anyway? Oh, it must be that. I'll just do the cave then, since I already touched the cave. I need to explain something to Reltek and everybody that's watching. I have to pee. I do have to pee real bad. I was so focused for a while, I just gotta pee now. One moment. But yeah, 4 days left for my dream wheel to spin and a winner to win. It should be interesting, guys. Like, in 4 days, 4.5 days, I guess, when Nightbot picks one of you to play a video game to win, you know, to win Steam money, a lot of money, it's like, how many people are really going to join? Like, unless it's such a bad idea that nobody does it, like, nobody wants to risk my wheel. Like, I don't care how you play it. You could use a ROM, I don't give a fuck, but... Like, however you get to the end credits, on a real cartridge or not. Hey Sigma, are you gonna join my Dream Wheel raffle giveaway? It's a giveaway and a raffle, and it's a Dream Wheel spin. But like when you guys make a wheel for me, it's just called the Viewer's Dream Wheel raffle. But like I'm just wondering if you're gonna join it. And I do wonder if you do join Sigma, if you win, what are you gonna cross your fingers for? You're allowed to boost the wheel. Everybody's allowed to boost the wheel right now. We went from a cave song to this cave song. It looks like auto battle's kind of rough. Alright, have fun, zombie. It must be nice being 20 again. Must be nice being age 20. So you're only a year back of me? Oh yeah, I think you did say that, right? You're only like 10, you're like, God, you're like 11 months back of me only. You don't want to join my raffle? Even to win? What if it's Dragon Quest 1, you know? It could be DQ1, you could beat the game on the Switch. The Switch version would be the fastest, so fast that you would be done in about 6 hours. And then that would be a GG. Light of Retribution? What the fuck kind of spell is that? Light of Redemption? Where the hell's the Retribution one at? Unless it was Redemption the whole time. I wonder if I can warp back to town from the dungeon. Here's that person here. I obtained some kind of sword. What the hell? I'll see you, Eden. I should be a lot farther tomorrow as well, because it's only a 10-hour game, so I'll see you tomorrow. This is a much more manageable dungeon, but... I wonder if I already did the story trigger for this place. Elixir of Life. Elixir of Life needs to go to him for sure. Maybe the Traveler's Sword is what I needed for the cutscene. Zombie is age 20, doubled! Death's Path? Weird. Death's Path was obtained. I don't think it says anything about it in here. Death's Path or Pact? What the fuck? It's called Pact there, and then it's called Path in the other thing. That definitely sucks, Sigma. That sucks. Like, just to tell you, Sigma, like, FF is a lot more popular and very noobish. So if, let's say that I do an FF-only wheel, you know, next year, like, the prize amount is going to be way lower than 60. Much, 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 much lower than 110, and definitely lower than 60. Because people like FF so goddamn much that they would pay to play FF, not get money to play FF. They would pay, right? So I shouldn't have to really throw up much of anything other than $20 for an FF game, just because of the popularity. So, like, take 60 while you can get it. I did a practice stream on Kick, I think, a few weeks ago, Realtek. I wish I could just stream on both and see what both chat rooms are like, but... That seems risky to go through that. I agreed to do it, though. Oh, I just exited the dungeon. Anyway, I think I might have did the story trigger, possibly. It depends on what wins, Sigma, because you could maybe rage quit and get nothing. You could always rage quit. If it's 7, you could rage quit, get nothing. And then I'll just move on to the next thing. Okay, who did I talk to start this? Somebody in the upper corner here? I already saw the sun, though. Oh, there we go. It was a little bit boring over there, Realtek. I went to the retro category over there. I don't think I met anybody. I don't think anyone found me at all. There was a dialogue option? You're kidding me. I hope he's able to continue to do this. What? You were right about saving. You were actually right about saving. And now I can't get that secret thing there. Because it's all done. That was a useless waste of time. Yeah, I can't reset because I haven't saved in an hour. So I just overwrote the save too, and now I'm fucked. Well, now to go back to that other village that you wanted me to go to. What did I miss out on the artifact? I wonder which one it was. If it was revived, then I just permanently destroyed my quest and there's no way to beat the game with monks only. Mm-hmm. So which guard am I supposed to talk to? Okay, I found Fortress, so that's done. I really don't know where to go next. One final hour left, Rhaegar. One final hour left. I don't know where I should go next. Not necessarily. Leveling up on the map is a little bit crappier. The auto battle wastes his MP right away. The encounter rate is a little lower on the map. It's probably higher here. What the hell is this? There's a little bit of smoke right there, but I think it's a way to get back to the entrance quicker. I don't remember seeing that at all. So the death's paths are always in every cave now, it feels like. This is better money and XP down here. Yeah, this is, it's not even an indie game, barely. Of course it is, I guess, but it's probably just, I would assume it's just stupid RPG Maker. It was probably a random fucking kid that made it, to be honest. My brother's game is days away now, trust. It's finally, my brother's game is in very early August, so the next game I'm doing is his game, so it seems that I'm going to be on Steam for a little while. This game is only 10 hours, though, trust, 10 hours, so I might have to find a buffer game to play after this, while waiting for my brothers. Yeah, I don't know if I want to backtrack, because I'll probably fuck up again, and then the NPC's gonna fuck me and then not give me the reward. So there's no point in backtracking. Unless it's revive or something, there's just no point in backtracking. I'd rather move forward after I feel strong enough to decimate on auto battle. Five ever? Oh god. There's a Columbine RPG? Nice. Is it in the perspective of the bad guys or the students? Students that ran. It's been 24 years. I'm allowed to laugh. Revive probably would be later, I would think, but spells are clearly not my kind of thing on a party like this. You know, a monk party that can't even get spells. Holy shit, that bitch! He's fucking dead. Oh, I think he got one-shotted from some stupid spell. Fucking bitch. I have to use outside only. Wait a minute, I wonder if I should go to a different town entirely. Like a weaker town. It might be cheaper to revive. It could be cheaper, I'm not sure. I must have gone to the wrong town. I don't see a reviver. I meant to go to the first town, but I think that's a specific spell, as we discussed. It's this. I meant to go here. Oops. Nope, it's still too expensive to revive. Regardless of where I am, it's too expensive. Free shit on Steam Stream. I played Mario Party 7 a few days ago to fill in time. Two weeks ago, I played WWE on the GameCube. The GameCube is hooked up a lot. I really don't know. I thought you saw the VOD by now. I thought you would have seen the VOD to see what I chose. Oh, that might have been the VOD where everything was all technical support. That might have been the shitty VOD with all the tech support. So you might have to go back another VOD entirely to go see that. If you want to know what I grabbed, I can't really remember, but it might be in the key items menu, right? So I should be able to show you. I'll go into my key items menu if you want to know. The Authority of Kings, I thought, was the thing that I chose. Or maybe it's a skill that you're talking about? King's Return, Healing Mists. It's in one of these. Light of Redemption. Increases critical hit rate. Huh. Reduces enemy encounters. Whoa! Protects against crits. That's crazy. Reduces encounter rate. That's fucking crazy. I don't even know that I had that. I'm not allowed to use it in a cave? I think I grabbed everything that I could grab. I'm starting to remember now. Reduces the chance of enemies, but I'm not allowed to use it. Oh, it's okay, that's passive, so that's why the encounter rate is not... It's not Digimon bad. It's not Digimon bad. Should I go to the northwest of the world map to see what's next? Because it feels like I can go to Hellbeast Cave, find a town called Andrew Cuomo. It says Cuomo. The town of Cuomo, same spelling. I might have gone up the middle door, perhaps, but... Wow, I decimated that battle quick. Hey, Reltek, are you there, Reltek? I want to tell Reltek the entire point of my RPG quest goal from the beginning, which does not include this or anything that is indie at all, because that's obviously clearly not the point of this channel. But it's okay that I'm playing indie a couple times. Just a few times I'll play indie stuff. It's because it was Dreamwheel, so it's okay to play it. But like, there's a difference between having a goal and then going outside of your goal sometimes just to have a little bit of fun. The primary goal, of course, is to play everything on all those systems. All the systems that I've kind of listed before on my layout. Nintendo, Sega, Sony, all the consoles and whatnot. Not including anything that is indie. And that's a really, really cool goal, and a good idea for this channel that I made 11 years ago. Because it guarantees that we're gonna see a legit copy of everything official, everything first party and third party, but not indie. Indie is just like, I'm doing it for fun on the side. It seems like I do this so much that I'll probably get to everything anyway. There's nothing better to me than playing a first or third party RPG. all the RPGs on all the systems, because those games have budget. They have huge budget. They have such good budget that they become good. They have a masterful, like, musical musician and all this other stuff as well. What is the closest to here? Oh, the Bluebird? Yeah, the Bluebird is close. I think you missed it, but you probably missed it, but I already went into the Bluebird for a while. I'm not sure if I maxed that place necessarily, because I died a few times and had to leave. But here, I'll just go back to the Bluebird and try to go deeper in. A lot of it's done, though. Where's Wangun? Oh, wait a minute. Don't I have 2,500 bucks now? I can go back to that one town now. I can go back to Fortress. And afford that one thing. Or was it not Fortress? It was the town that... It was only 2,500 bucks. Here it is. Okay, now I might go to the left side one. Max HP went up by 30. For everybody in the party, I think? It must be everybody in the party. Let me into the others, please. Anyway, where's Wangun? Wangun. I'm looking at the map now, but I don't know where Wangun is. I did a lot of the Bluebird Forest here, but I'll just show you. Yeah, this was kind of a long place. A lot of hallways. She does not want me to fight that boss, apparently. Requires a random key? Which key? I never went to the east to see them. That crit was needed because I can only attack one on these assholes. Very bad XP for that kind of long, long battle. This is the direction I went the first time, because I don't remember that lady blocking a boss. I think I remember seeing this dead end. Uh-oh, we fell through. Free experience obtained, and that's pretty much it. Damn, this place just continues on. And there are enemies here. Yeah, the rock piles suck. Traveler's hat. Elixir of wisdom. Oh my god, Mike himself is the one that needs to have it. Eventually my dudes end up critical hitting and killing him, so there is a way to win. With a melee-only party. I wonder why I'm in a different dungeon now. Holy crap, we found a large axe. A longbow to sell for money. Paradox clocks? Okay, part of me feels like that's some kind of time move. Disorients an enemy group, that's all it is. Yeah, that's all it is. Now I feel good enough about that dungeon, other than the side quest. I kind of want something harder now. Harder to do. Where's the town of Wangun, if you can direct me on the world map image online? It might be time to buy a bunch of herbs again. Savings quick. What if I forgot to buy any real equipment, or not? It seems to be good, everything's bad there. Oh, it's something east. Oh, I see it now, yep. It's a little north and then east, and then there it is. And then there's a poison cave. Well, that's where the final boss is close to. Traveler's sword? I might have to sell Traveler's sword, believe it or not. The large axe has to be really old by now, so screw that. I might need to sell Traveler's sword, because I have a hunter's blade. Let's just check first to make sure. The attack is worse. I don't know, it was given to me by the storyline, I feel like, but they are allowing me to sell it, the Traveler Sword. I could also put it away in the storage. $750. Why would this one sell for a very large amount? It must be special in some odd way? I'll just head for Wangun then. Okay, we're about to find Wangun. There should be a poison cave right there. The final boss is really close to that. Is there crazy lag on the game sounds? I don't think anyone said that. Therefore, it's not true. Yeah, it sounds normal to me. It could just be the producer, maybe. It's hard to say. Ooh, we have a new town with very expensive things. Yeah, this is extremely short, Miz. Brutally, brutally short. What the fuck? I'm not allowed to check if I can wear it because I don't have the money to check. That's really dumb, like I don't have the money to check if I'm allowed to have any of that. That's insanely dumb. There's a lot of arrows here.
That's the storage room.
I need to buy the, you know, the key, or... I need to buy whatever you mentioned, Rhaegar, in this town. I think I have to find someone kidnapped. The poison place should be really irritating to do, man. Oh, 5,000? I don't have enough by a couple dollars, I think. I have to go outside and fight a battle, or do this instead. How much is it? Oh, 15,000. Ouch. Are you talking about the $5,000 sword? I think Rhaegar, you might be way behind on the VOD. I'm not sure why the sounds would have lag either. That's kind of weird too. The left room is silence. The middle room is exploding. And the right one is a berserk spell. Ooh, the right side one is what I would want here. Yeah, Rhaegar's gonna have to refresh. I might as well spend all the money on the warp spell for now. I'll be back to being broke again. Which means I can't afford to die. I just need to fight one battle to get enough money for that warp spell. Happened to the encounter rate. It's all fucking poison enemies. Everything's poison for the next hour of gaming. Okay, that gave me a very bare minimum of money. Drill for some odd reason, and gain levels. Sure what it will do. It could be just optional. Do you know how to upload to YouTube? Unless you don't have a channel? Come at me, Brett. Oh god, he does 390 damage. That was a pretty good attack by me, though. Alex is long dead, though. Critical hit, that helps. I have a kill or be killed party, and I'm almost fully dead. It's down to one motherfucker. One guy with no heals. He's a good test to see if you're powerful yet. He should have died, though. I felt like it was far enough in the battle that he could have died with a little bit more work. I picked an all melee party trust. That's all I did. Google Drive has like enough space and room for you to do such things. There's another town right here. What the hell? He wants me to leave no matter what. This is really close to where the final boss is. I'll have to whisper you. Unless you don't have Google Drive at all, then that's a little rough. But by the way, Ragar, the fucking like Steam sharing or the not sharing, what is it called? The cloud saves are not really working though, you know? Like, if I go on the deck right now, well, the game can't load, so never mind, though. But if I go on my regular computer, the one I'm streaming on right now, it's not going to say that I have a quest on this game, because there's no such thing as cloud saves. You know, so I might be stuck on the laptop forever, regardless. Enchanted helmet. That could be good. Nope, it's only five. It's only five better, but it's something at least. Oh, you already said it doesn't work? Huh. The running chance is extremely hard in this game, but I'm pretty much about to game over. I don't want to get experience points with someone dead because he is just so far behind everybody else. He's died so many goddamn times, it's sickening to me. I forgot where the exit was, too. And it had to be four enemies again. Everything looks the same, so I don't know where the exit is. Oh, bitch. Oh, bitch. I found a bunch of chests, but not the exit. Smoke bombs are $500, so that's out of the question to spend such money. How did I lose the exit, for fuck's sake? I guess the $3,000 chest is gonna have to revive everybody. But it's thousands and thousands just to revive one person. Oh shit, I ended up finding something. It might be a guaranteed battle to even earn it. I'm right next to an escape portal. I can't believe I ran away. I might have completed the dungeon just on random pure luck. Just out of pure luck. What is Wind's grave? Just take a picture of where Wind's grave is. Do a screen capture of where that is on that map. Did the first town have a reviver? Yes, it has to. Why would the warrior be $1,500 to revive, and then the fucking monk is only $700 to revive him? I could go back to that place. I saved. I was able to save. I lost all my money, though. The revival fees are so brutal. I don't have enough money. I'm out of money by about 80 bucks. I don't think fighting near the beginning is gonna be smart. So let's just get risky and fight here. It depends on what Windsgrave would have in it for me. For a melee party that I have. Now I can buy that dumb guy's spell. It's probably not that good for a melee party that I have. This game was meant for magic, I feel like, because it's all the artifacts are. What I probably need to do is stay around here and just, well, I could go into that dungeon. The encounter rate is a little crappy out on the world map. It's too slow. What's up, bullet? I'm playing Ragnar's Chosen video game. It's on Steam. The Steam Deck does not allow it to work though, so I'm on a fucking laptop. Which castle? The primary first castle in the game? You can see what classes I chose, bullet, on the right side of the stream. That's really good XP, though. See, if this worked on the Steam Deck, then I could actually, like, grind. The point to this game, bullet, is to kill the Swamp King, and then you're at the end credits. So there's nothing else at all except kill the Swamp King, and then you're at the end credits. But along the way, you just have to grind heavily. And find random-ass, like, things on the way. I do wonder if going to the clinic will fucking heal this poison, though. I can't get along being poisoned for long. I'm poisoned and I walked on poison. That's double the damage. Hey, Bullet, the encounter rate is literally, like, way, way less than Digimon. Much less than Digimon. It's quite funny to me. I guess there's no point in making the clinic guy an antidote healer, because I can just find a shot myself, I suppose. They're not poisoned anymore, technically. Here, I'm gonna go to the inn. Oh shit, the inn is extremely brutally expensive. Fucking piece of shit. The jar's where now? Fuck, they're still poisoned after the inn. I didn't think they would be. I just hate manually healing. It's like an old Dragon Quest menu. It just takes long. Well, you're lucky I'm in the first castle town now, so I can just go there. I thought I already would have done what you're typing, though. Oh, yeah. Oh, God, it's Globe Man. Globe Man is the channel greeter. This must be the second floor. Oh, the right side room is that weird jar. Wait, isn't the weird jar thing that stupid guy here? There's nowhere to go on the right. Oh, wait a minute. Sun and Moon? What is this, Pokemon? Borg obtained the power, because he's the one walking. Changes night to day, but it's free. Completely free to use it. The thrill of victory? Causes enemies to attack my party? Well, that's really great. That sounds awful. Plated headband? Looks like the monks finally have a fucking piece of defense to equip for a change. It's just like FF1. There's a lack of equipment for monks. Oh, I have to get 25 now for the next chest. So those stupid creatures are still required to be finding. Anyway, Ragar, 20 minutes left approximately of gaming now. So all I need to really do at the moment is just like grind. Grind near the town of Wangan, even though I keep getting poisoned. This way is, this way leads to a volcano village. I don't really need to do that village. Unless you know where the warping thing is for it, but... If I go to the inn, I can just get that super tech refreshed and level up that way, but... I don't know. I really don't know. Wait, Volcano Village is on the other side, I think, of those mountains. Which is not good, because I cannot reach it. Oh, the drill cave is right here, and I have a drill. I don't think these enemies are poisoning me on this side, so that's good news. This is Drill Cave, and it looks exactly the same as the other caves. Even on the directions. Holy crap, these are weird-looking bugs. Jeez. quite the battle. These beetles have so much defense. Yeah, I'm just trying to like finish up by leveling, but I keep getting curious and going into new caves when I should not do that. Can only get the one. That was a lot of XP. That was a great battle. Two poison people though. Fuck. Looks like I found a random person, but I might not have triggered the story for it. Ragar, your whole dream wheels and whatnot have put me in a good mood. Digimon was a 67, which is a bad score, but it puts me in a very good mood to just get farther in my channel's point, you know? I did more Digimon now, and now there's a little bit more to do. No, the monks are acting like... They're just acting like monks from FF1. Everybody kind of acts like FF1 classes, basically. You'll have to ask Ragar what the other classes are. Because I don't even remember now. There's definitely a black mage type thing. I just got free XP for some odd reason. Oh, I made it to the other side. You know, honestly, the reason why I didn't pick a healer bullet, I know it's going to be risky. It's going to be very risky, but I didn't do it because, like, remember less than a year ago? Like, it was 2022. The end of 2022, I did FF1. Remember, I did FF1, the Mages Only quest. Mages Only. I did hard mode. FF1, PS1 version, hard mode. Mages Only, and... I just wanted to do the exact opposite because I was not in the mood for mages again. You know, I just was not. I might be able to level up in the volcano tomorrow. Like, a lot. Hey, Bullet, do you care to join the thing 4 days from now? Do you see the bot command? $2,000 to stay at this piece of shit town? I need to get the fast travel for this town, so I don't have to walk back. There's a shaman, hermit, gunslinger. The gunslinger is an archer, pretty much in every way. And a dreamer, I can't remember. Remember, the challenge bullet in 4 days has to do with winning a very big deal on Steam. You know, $60. I don't care if Dragon Quest 1 wins. Yeah, like, for you, if you wanted $60 so bad, like, you would have to pray to God that Dragon Quest 1 wins because it's shorter. Let's meet at the tunnel? Hey, Ragar, I need the fast travel in this town. The game gets a little choppy, to be honest. It looks like my stream is running fine. Is it running fine? I can't tell. Maybe it was never running fine the whole time, like, all night. It might have never been running good all night. I just didn't know. Maybe the sound's better, too. What do I use to stream? Are you talking about, are you talking about Avermedia? The Avermedia card? Yeah, I forgot to go to that one option that fixes an issue. That stupid daily issue thing. So there's no warp back here, which is really bad. I hope she means this tunnel. I already have permission from that bitch. Technically, I already have permission from the girl, so... Oh, she left. Well, let me see. It does. You see how the game chops a little bit, though? It's chopping a little. 3,500,000. I mean, $35,000. I see. Maybe he unblocked the whole community. Nope, he left me blocked. I don't even want to talk about it today. Free XP and free money? I hope the new follower checks out the score sheet there. I really hope that the volcano ends up being a great place. Holy shit, it's destroyed. It became Hawksness. Flame shield has been found. I'll equip it outside so we can hear music. Probably the right person I want to equip it with anyway. Oh, the toxic blade. It has poison on it, but it's worse. It's a lot worse. I need to go back to the... Wait a minute. Did this town that was destroyed, did it have a weapon shop with all the expensive stuff? Or was that before? The puppy has arrived, and he's gigantic, extremely gigantic, after only 5 months. He's a very, very good boy. Yes, he is. He's extremely, extremely heavy. He's gotta be 60 pounds. 5 months, brand new, brand new. Okay, that's how we know there's a few, there's only a few more minutes left. Because I always get off around now to take him out and whatnot. But, I wish I could use that volcano or this volcano as a leveling. They're all dead. He still won't let me pass. Huh. Oh, the choice that I made, huh? Well, there's gonna be a way to grind, nonetheless. This nice little tunnel, I don't think has too much poison status in it. Actually, that money was extremely good, though, Ragar. I wanted to go to a town and go use it. Let's go see if I can at least go use all the money for upgrades. I think Wangan is the only place that I have a warp for. This... nighttime. It looks like they're all gone at nighttime. 200 to stay? I don't really need to do 200 to stay. I can do the one that's like 15 to stay. I think Greenvale was really cheap on staying. Only 12. Might as well save. I guess that town has been destroyed. Okay, now let's see what I should upgrade. I'm gonna try to get attack power, weapons, something. Let's go to sell first. Should I get rid of the Traveler's Sword anyway? Because it seems sellable. I did. I actually did. Let's see. Toxic Blade has a property of poisoning, but it's weaker, so I sold it. Steel Helmet's gone, I suppose. That's gone. Leather Armor is all the monks can equip, so it's pretty bad. Plated Headband is still there. Okay, now we have, the longsword is only 3 better. 6 better for the battle axe, but worse defense? I definitely do not want the worst defense. I think 3 better is a little unfair. It's too expensive to only have 3 better. I only need 1 night shield. I only need 1 enchanted helmet, and then the plate mail would be the best improvement for both people. That's why I went with warriors, not just monks only, because it would be extra hard. What does 66 point plus 3 add up to, though, Trust? I'm just asking. I think Mike was always really behind on equipment and defense, so he's super buffed out now on everything. He's super buffed. Traveler's Hat is gone, I guess. That's gone. That's gone. I have enough to revive in case there's a total meltdown that happens. This was the testing guy. I still don't want to really fight him yet. For three more attack power, I can try to afford that one weapon. I'll go back east where there's less poison enemies. My best course of action is to probably just grind on purpose for a bunch of hours. It's the best way to get into the level 20s. See, I feel like these are non-poison enemies. Plus, they died. There's a bridge over here. That's it. I need to just save the world map to my computer. And then open it up. Open it up myself and zoom in. Perfect, I can finally zoom in because I saved it. Oh, actually, yeah, this is going down. Oh, Ragart's going down into a beast camp. Steep price? Huh. Yeah, gold seems to be massively important in this game. You could break the game if you had a gold code. The game would be broken. I would never make a game like relying on gold only. I would make a game like Dragon Quest where it's like half important but not 100%. There's something called Beast Camp here, and then there's Eluta. South of here is Eluta. Do you know if... Oh my god, there's a whole bunch of chests. 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. And please be 69. Please be 69. 100. Nope, it's an elixir. Boost speed. I'll do it for Mike, because he has all the spells. He's gonna need the speed. Just like yesterday on the other video game. I'm glad I stuck with this game to make it to work on Steam. Because it's just a little quick addiction game. An addiction game that's getting closer to the 75, but we have to kill the final boss to see if it deserves that full score. Oh, it's not quite there yet. That dude is hiding on the outer edge. Oh, what the hell? He's gone? Hey, Ragar, should I go to Iluta in the south here? It's not really that risky to walk on the world map, because I can always use return back to safety in the first town in the game if I want. Oh my god, the desert towers around this goddamn area. I should focus on doing the forest tower first, not desert. I hope Iluta has a warping spell thing. Pretty insane enemies here. Iluta has been found. Are you saying this is a fishing village? 320 to stay the night. Saving is here. I see one of those creatures walking around. Oh, crap. I have to get that creature quick. Oh, thank God. Elixir of Fortitude. Fortitude, Sigma. Is it testicular fortitude? He's selling the three main items in the game, plus all the bullets for bullet. Bullets for bullet. I found a jar goblin. What's next, an anal goblin? Blind puzzles? I'm not sure what you mean by blind like this. Oh god. I think I saved when I first got here, so I'm okay there. At least I saved when I first got here. Ooh, it's one of those dudes. Yeah, this is one of these puzzles that is totally blind. We don't know where it's gonna take me at any point. Yeah, this puzzle's too random. Too oddly random. There's no battles. Oh crap, that's the exit. I mean, finding the exit is good, but unless it's not the exit. Warp for the town? Yeah, that's what I need extremely badly. Oh, come on, he's over there? That bitch. Well, I found one chest, and it is the warp to this town. Oh, it took me out? Whoa, that took me out even more. It ended up taking me out. This'll eat up the rest of the stream, I feel like. It's crazy. I need one of those little dudes. And then there's another chest. Oh, sweet, I got him. Unless there's a second one to the left. I'll choose that one. As long as I remember that I did. Wonder if they always go the same way. Let's go down here? I probably did that before. I feel like I've been the beginning of the puzzle. Whoa, that's different. Oh, I think it is pretty randomized. Elixir of Magic. So I have to leave now. Do you think that's it, Ragar? Is that good enough? I don't want to go back in there. Was there only two chests and one of the tiny creatures? Because if so, then I am 100% done for sure with that whole place. Mike got the MP for sure. Okay, then I succeeded. Let's get the hell out of here. Let's take that literally, Truss. Let's literally get the fuck out of here. Okay, that is a GG, guys. As we hear the evil Dragon Quest music in a cave. Remember, guys, 4 days, 22 hours left until my wheel is spun here. There's that score sheet. I think what I'll do is I'll go to close game, I guess, and I'm gonna have to put the laptop on sleep mode. I'll have to switch to Dragon Quest II music for tomorrow, because this soundtrack is clearly almost done. Thank you, Ragar, for the help today. I'll try to grind as much as possible. Next stream is tomorrow already. Two total for tomorrow for sure. This is such a good final boss song, though. The very, very first JRPG series ever invented, and they really got that final boss song down. Alright guys, like I said, two total streams, and I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Thank you, Ragar. Ragar, the game is so short that I might as well just keep going on the laptop. There's no point in, you know, being on the go with a deck. Because it's just not deck ready, it's not Linux ready. It is not ready. In any way. Everybody have a good night.